Hey ladies, it's Trish here from onethirdchiclet.blogspot.com, and today I'm changing it up a little bit and I'm not using a Cricut cartridge for once. I know, shocker, Create a Critter's out and everybody's doing awesome videos with it, but I wanted to do something a little bit different. I wanted to incorporate ribbon in my card. So this is the card that I'm using. It is an A2 size card, however it is cut at 11 inches by 4 1/4, and it's scored at 5 1/2. So that it does create the card a longer way. You can use it upright or sideways. I chose to do mine sideways. And then we have the two layers. The white layer is 4 by 5 1/4, and the pink layer is 3 3/4 by 5 inches. So essentially what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna have these three ribbons on the card, and I wanted to use the ribbon punch that I have with it. So what I did is I measured it out so that everything's evenly. I measured 1/2 inch from the top of the card, and I drew a line, and I put it on the front of the card because it will be covered up by the layers. So I did 1/2 inch, and then following that I did 3/4 inch, and I did another 3/4 inch, and then I marked off 3/4 inch from the crease mark. Okay, and so the top ribbon is going to be a little bit shorter, then it'll be slightly longer in the middle, and then the longest piece of ribbon will be the bottom piece. And then at each line I pretty much punched it. Let's see if I can show you it this way. And so the I wanted it to be off center, so the top and bottom one will be will show a little bit more ribbon, and the center one will show a little bit less ribbon. So the top and bottom, I just used my X-Acto knife and cut a slit right at the score marks, and then I punched following that, whereas in the middle I actually punched right at the beginning and then proceeded through. So I did the bottom layer, and I already punched through the pink or the white one, and I just wanted to leave this one so that I could show you just how I did it. And I'll probably end up fast forwarding through this, because if not I will go over time as I usually do, and my husband has to then edit it. So now all we're going to do is attach the layers onto one another. Now be careful when you go on the side that is actually attached to the closest to the crease mark, because you don't want to cover up your ribbon holes. So you want to go around it. And you want to line up your ribbon punch. I can't do it sitting down, so let me stand up and check that out. Because if not, your ribbon will not feed through. Now, ideally, you could do the bottom, the base of the card, and then attach the two layers on the top and then punch through, because it would make it a little bit easier for you. But since I wanted to show you how I set up the bottoms of the card, or how I actually measured everything out, that's why I left it and did the other two pieces. Okay. So now is basically just feeding your ribbon. Okay, ladies, so there's what the ribbon looks like all thread through. I had to fight with it for a little bit, but that's what it looks like. I think it came out really good. If I do this method a second time, though, I would like to try it with the ribbon closer so that it's literally right against each other, but I still like the way it came out. So the last thing we're going to do is I'm going to emboss my sentiment on the card. It's going to say "just because." Now be careful that your ribbon doesn't get in the way of you actually stamping your sentiment. It looks like I got it there. Okay. We're going to use some clear embossing powder. Actually, you know what? I'm going to do white. to go over it a second time in case I missed anywhere on there. And just flick the card, make sure you get all that extra off. Use our heating tool. And there you have it. And there's our card for tonight. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and stay tuned for the next one.